Welcome to the Bottom Line Live. So tonight we are going to talk about when you should get a bookkeeper. And I want to preface this with the fact that this might be a little bit different for every company and every person. So I don't want anyone to take anything I say as like an invalidation of the size of their company or anything like that. Okay, before I forget, I better share this because I'm started talking already and I need to share this into the Wealth Dynamics page for all their exclusive viewers. Join the Wealth Dynamics page, by the way. It's like super useful. I've learned a lot being on it and I post a lot on it. So if you want to see more content from me, which I know you all do because I'm talking about your favorite subject, my favorite subject, bookkeeping. The Bottom Line Live. I feel like Jerry already shared it for me, but I'm gonna share it again in case he didn't. All right, so. I'm going to go back to this, my disclaimer, what I was saying. Thanks for joining me, guys. I love that I have this fan base that actually tunes in every week at 7 o'clock to learn about bookkeeping, which is the most exciting subject. Jerry actually wants me to write a book, and I need to figure out a title for it, because the best title I can come up with is How to Make Bookkeeping Sexy, and bookkeeping is just not that sexy. So what do we really call this, Jerry? We should do a poll. Come up with good ideas for a name for a book about bookkeeping. Otherwise, I'm going to steal Jerry's name, and it's going to be called The Blueprint to Bookkeeping. Okay, so when should you hire a bookkeeper? I know this is going to be different for every company. You know, you might be a smaller company and you hate doing bookkeeping and you're ready to get to hire someone right away to do it. You might be a bigger company and you have three bookkeepers. Hi, Jerry. You might have three bookkeepers, you know, working in-house in your company, and you might just want an outsourced person to review your books every quarter. You know, we do all of that. So there's going to be different things, but I'm going to give you guys kind of basic guidelines of where you are in your business that would be a good time to get a bookkeeper, or different situations that you might be running into. Again, keep in mind, this is going to be different for you, for everybody. Like, I have met people who, I'm looking for my little promo that Jerry made me because it's awesome. And then I can remember all the things I wanted to tell you guys. Okay, so I've met people who like doing bookkeeping. I mean, first of all, I own a bookkeeping firm, so everyone who works for me that does bookkeeping actually likes doing bookkeeping. So guys, people who like doing bookkeeping exist. So if you own a company and doing the bookkeeping is one of your favorite things to do, nobody is saying that you're not allowed to do it. So just everything I say, take it with a grain of salt of it has to work for you. Oh, is Jerry coming up with a title name for my new book? We keep your books so you can keep your money. Oh, that's good. That's good. I like that. And then underlined, it's going to be how to make bookkeeping sexy again. Because it is. Or maybe it just should be called like red lipstick, how to make bookkeeping sexy again, right? Okay, but we keep your books so you can keep your money. I like that. That's good. Anybody else wants to put in new book titles for me to write about bookkeeping? I don't know that this book's going to be written right away, but it's on my list of things to do. Feel free to come up with suggestions. Okay, so here's, I'm gonna go into this, and here's what I want to talk about, because right now, we're wrapping up kind of like reviewing 2021 books so that CPAs can do taxes. It's pretty much done. You know, we've sent out final questions for all of our clients. But I have had people email me, call me, reach out to me, and say, "Hey, can you get all my bookkeeping done for the last 2 years by March 9th?" And I just have to say, "No, I can't. I'm sorry. Like we're doing other people's that already came to us earlier." So if you have 2 years of bookkeeping to do and you need help, now's a good time to get a bookkeeper. That would be, if you're not doing any bookkeeping, that would be a great time to get a bookkeeper. The likelihood you're going to get all your bookkeeping done before March 15th so you can file your taxes on time if you have a year or two of bookkeeping to do right now is slim to none. But you can file an extension, get your books done now so they're ready for September. So keep that in mind. Ooh, new book title suggestion from Jerry. How not to go to jail. Ooh. This is why Jerry does lots of marketing because he's smart about this stuff. How not to go to jail. That's a very good title. I like that. Okay. So this also has to do with a subject that we've talked about before, LLCs, S corporations, things like that. If you are an S corporation, just that alone has enough going on in it, you most likely need a bookkeeper. Again, if you love doing your own bookkeeping and you're very confident that everything's accurate, and as Jerry says, that you're not going to go to jail, you're probably doing great. But a lot of people who start a company don't start it because they like doing bookkeeping. They start it because they like doing whatever it is that their company is, whether a doctor, a lawyer, actor, marketing company, that's what they're good at doing. That's what they like doing. So most people, if you have an S corporation, you need a bookkeeper at that point. Like maybe if you have a brand new S corporation and you're still, under the $100,000 range, maybe you don't need a bookkeeper yet, but pretty much you do because as soon as you do an S corp election, you have to have payroll. Even doing the S corp election itself takes work, right? So keep that in mind as a general rule of thumb. If you have an S corp, you need help on your bookkeeping, most likely. Even if it's just like consultation or help setting up payroll. And I'm never going to say you guys can't do this yourself. If you want to take the time to do the research for every state that you have employees in or the states that you're in and you want to set up the payroll yourself and you want to do 1099s yourself, power to you. I get it. You're allowed to. If you don't want to do it yourself or you don't have time to do it or you don't feel confident or skilled in it, which I'm going to imagine is 99.7% of company owners, that's when you reach out and get a bookkeeper, right? Even if it's, guys, listen, maybe you know how to do most of it yourself and it's real easy, but get a consultation to get set up on payroll or hire a bookkeeper to get you set up on payroll and then you can run it yourself or whatever it is, right? If your company is making $100,000 or over and you are not an S corporation yet, you need a bookkeeper because you need someone to tell you that you should be an S corporation. There's obviously some situations that your CPA might go over with you that it wouldn't be a good time for you to be an S corp, but I'm going to say 98% of the time, if you're making over $100,000 as an LLC or sole proprietorship, you want to have the S corp election. You might not know about that, so you might need a bookkeeper to tell you now's the time to do your S corp election. I've also seen people who just start out their company and the company's really, really small and they go do an S corp election, and I think that's a waste of your time and money because now you're doing all this stuff that you have to do for an S corp with only, 20,000 revenue for the year, and it's just not worth it. So the LLC has legal protection. The S corporation has tax ramifications and benefits, right? So let's keep that in mind. You probably don't need an S corp election or an S corp until you're over $100,000 in revenue. Once you are over $100,000 in revenue, close to, depending on your profit margin, it could be $80,000 for you, whatever, right? But when you get around there, you probably want a bookkeeper, you probably want an S-corp election, and you might not need like a monthly bookkeeping situation. You might just need someone to help you set up your payroll. You know, like I recently helped a bunch of small companies set up their payroll, kind of like get their S-corp elections, all that, so that they're good to go. But here's the thing, there is paperwork to do. There is bookkeeping that has to get done, whether you do it or not, whether you like it or not. So you can either pay someone to do it for you, or you can get trained on how to do it yourself, depending on your financial situation. We do have a lot of business owners that are in the 500,000 to 15 million range, and they wouldn't even have time to do their bookkeeping if they wanted to. I don't even know how they have time to sleep, right? So if you are making a lot of money, or a lot of money is relative depending on who you are, you need a bookkeeper, right? I know I've said several times, if you're not making money, then the IRS can't tax you. The reverse is true. If you are making money, the IRS is going to tax you as much as they possibly can. So you need really good record keeping so that you're only paying what you need to the IRS. You need to make sure that you're counting all of your deductions that you possibly can, that you are on payroll. You know, S-corps are much less likely to get audited, but they are going to be more likely to get audited if you're an S-corp not on payroll. It throws up red flags to the IRS. So S-corp election, get yourself on payroll, all that. Okay, so now let's say you're making 100, 150, 200,000 a year for your company, and you're rolling along and everything is fine and you're doing the bookkeeping yourself, but you're so overwhelmed and you're not getting any sleep and you're getting these letters from the IRS and you don't know what to do with them and it's just getting really freaking stressful, get a bookkeeper. I'm trying to give lots of scenarios because I know there's lots of different people in different situations and financial situations or whatever. That would be the time to get a bookkeeper. You've been doing a great job. You've been doing it yourself. You've got it all under control, but maybe it's time to see your kids, or maybe it's time to get some sleep. Get a bookkeeper, right? Let's say you have someone part-time who, you know, it's like a bookkeeper who has a few clients and they're just kind of doing a little bit of bookkeeping for their friends and family or a few clients, and they just, it just feels like they don't have enough time for you. You're not getting your answers back. You know, they seem frazzled. Get a different bookkeeper. You know, go, you might be graduating to someone who has a bookkeeping company that has more time for you. You know, so keep that in mind. Let's say you have a $5 to $15 million revenue company and you have people doing bookkeeping in-house for you. Maybe your office manager, maybe you have a bookkeeper in-house and you want another set of eyes to make sure that they know what they're doing. Now's a great time to get a bookkeeper. You know, we have clients that we just go in and review it. Even internally, we do tons of reviews. Like those of you guys who are my clients, if you ever look at your invoices, you'll see bookkeeping review, no charge, bookkeeping review, no charge. We're not charging for it because it's just part of our quality control. But we check, the bookkeeper checks their bookkeeping, the lead bookkeeper checks it, and then I kind of spot check them throughout the year to make sure that I like what they look like and that my quality for my company is up. So we just do bookkeeping reviews. We have people come to us and say, hey, can you make sure my bookkeeper knows what they're doing? Can you make sure my office manager knows what they're doing? And we'll send you back an official looking report that says, you know, here's the things that should be fixed. I've never seen one that didn't have here's the things that should be fixed. Just because if you're coming and you're wanting a review, that means you're not sure, and maybe your bookkeeper isn't like a fully trained bookkeeper. But even if they are, you know, it's great to have another set of eyes because people miss things. Okay, are you someone that, you know, does all the hats in your company? Like, do you do all of the sales, all of the delivery? You know, maybe you have a few assistants or whatever, and you don't even have time to do the bookkeeping? Get a bookkeeper. Or for instance, okay, I've had clients who thought they were doing a pretty good job on their bookkeeping, and when I looked it over with them, they had expense accounts set up as bank accounts. Like they would have an account called fuel expenses as a bank account. So they thought they knew what they were doing, but they didn't. So, you know, I would say 75% of bookkeeping is really simple data entry, and that last 25% is what you need a really good bookkeeper for. So, stuff like that. I want to answer these questions. You know, I'm trying to go over lots of scenarios because I get asked all the time, well, when do you think I should hire a bookkeeper? So, when you're first starting out your business and you haven't made any money yet, I don't think you need a bookkeeper yet. Maybe you could use a consultation, right? Like you could set up a consultation and just go over, okay, what are the things I need to have? But I've even said this, and I'll say this again, and I know Nano reminds me I have to write this as a blueprint, but you need a business bank account, which in order to get, you would probably need your LLC, right? You can also do it as a sole proprietor, but you want one bank account that's only for business. And if you haven't done this yet, do it, and you'll thank me later because you'll see it makes life so simple. I have a client who just started working on that, separating out their business and their personal, and they hadn't done it in years, and they thought their bookkeeping was so complicated and confusing. And turns out that their business bookkeeping is actually really simple, and they just had everything mixed together, and that made it complicated. Several clients, but one that's working on that right now. So that's the first thing you need. You need your, you know, your LLC, or you can just do it as a sole proprietor, but you need one bank account that you only use for business to start out. It doesn't even have to be a business account if, you know, you don't have an LLC or whatever. It can just be a personal account, but you're only using it for business. You're gonna connect that to software. There's what's that software that we're using? TaxHurdler. So TaxHurdler, if you are just kind of like brand new, starting out, if you get a Mint Builder membership through Wealth Dynamics, you get a free TaxHurdler, and you can use that for your new business, because I know everybody should have a business, especially if they have like a high W-2 or whatever, right? So you get that going, you get started. You get a consultation of like, what types of things should I be looking for deductible? What should I be running through my business? How do I do these things? And you just get organized and you can start out. Now, within, you know, a few months or a year, you're making enough money to really hire someone to help you. You do a new consultation, you look through it again. Is this a good time to hire someone? You know, that would be a really smart way to start. I've had people, tell me, oh, I've been in business for 7 years. I'm making 1.5 million. I have no idea where my money is going. I have no idea how I do my taxes each year, but I don't have any bookkeeping and I've never had bookkeeping for 7 years. Like, I don't know, but that just sounds so painful to me. Like, to never know your numbers. And every year when you do your taxes, you probably have to go do that thing that everybody loves of sitting in a closet for 3 days with a box of receipts and bank statements and highlighters and try to figure it out and then come up with your best guess and give it to your CPA and hope you never get audited. You know, and maybe there's several cups of coffee and maybe some bottles of alcohol in the closet with you. But it's not the recommended way to go. It sounds super stressful for me, to me, right? What we're trying to do, our mission statement, is complete and perfect financial records for your peace of mind. So, what are you really getting when you hire a good bookkeeper? You're not just getting good financial records for your taxes, you're getting peace of mind. And I know because you guys all talk to me about this, how stressful it can be when you don't have that peace of mind, right? You don't know what your taxes are going to be. You don't know what you're supposed to be doing. You don't know what this letter is you got from the IRS. You don't know what your numbers are for your taxes. And you don't know if you can hire a person or not because you have no idea what your profit is. I could never live like that. I don't know how other people do. You know, maybe on lots of coffee. That's my best guess. But I know no one likes it because you guys are telling me. So I'm not saying anything you don't know. This is probably a very short webinar unless anybody has any specific questions for me. But you can always reach out to me. One thing is that I really care about all my clients and I want the best for them. So If I think that you're not at a point where you should be hiring a bookkeeper, I will tell you. And, you know, I've definitely learned ways to say it nicely, because some people are like, you know, could get offended. Like, are you trying to say we don't make enough money? No, that's not what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to say you have a newer company, and, you know, I've looked at your numbers, like as far as whatever you have, you know, you told me your income, and this might not be the best time to hire a bookkeeper. Maybe I can just show you how to use QuickBooks, something like that. But I've also had times where I go, listen, like, you need a bookkeeper right away. But I'm never going to sell you something you don't need. You know, I don't know. I mean, I hope no bookkeepers are, but we really want it to be the best fit for you and something that you actually need. Now, I know every company probably needs a bookkeeper. Can you afford it? Is it the right time? Can you just get some training and do it yourself? You know, whatever it is you need is what's right for you and what's best for you. And because I want you to have peace of mind, because that's my mission statement, that's what I'm gonna do. I have lots of people who aren't at the point yet where they need bookkeeping or they want to do it themselves, and we just do a consultation, you know, once a month, every few months, you know, 1 hour. We just go through their books and figure out, you know, how to categorize. I train them, I give them their next steps, and that's enough for them. Most likely within, you know, 6 months, a year and a half, they're going to be at a point where they do need a bookkeeper full time, because now they're so organized that they're making way more money. And that happens one for one. Like, I could probably give you guys case studies of people who I started helping get organized, and think of how many attention units you don't have to have on your books that you can use to expand your business and make more money. So, and I'm not even saying hire me, although of course I think you should hire my company. I'm just saying this is when you should get a bookkeeper, and there are milestones that, you know, you need to achieve. Like, you probably need to get your company to 100,000 revenue in order to pay a bookkeeper consistently. But up until then, you could pay a bookkeeper to set up your payroll, to S-corp your company, to teach you how to use QuickBooks, right? We do all these things, to review your books, right? And as you get bigger than that, you're gonna need a bookkeeper. Maybe if you're at 150, 200,000 revenue, you need bookkeeping quarterly. Maybe if you hit 500,000 revenue, you need bookkeeping every month. But sometimes people are looking at their financial plan every week. They want bookkeeping every week. We can do all that. Okay, so that's pretty much everything I had to say. If you have payroll, you most likely need a bookkeeper, whether you have someone in-house doing it or you hire a bookkeeper, because payroll is just gets more and more complicated with the years. Like, it is what it is. I don't really have anything else to say about that. And it looks like you guys are pretty much in agreement with me, because nobody's asking me any questions, which is totally fine, because you should get a bookkeeper. And so I'm going to probably close out in a minute here. Feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions, or if you have a good title for my book of How to Make Bookkeeping Sexy Again, which is not the title I can use, because bookkeeping is just not sexy, guys. It's just not. Okay, so feel free to reach out to me. You can message me on Facebook. You can email me. You can go to my website. It's solvencynow.com. My email is maya@solvencynow.com. You can message me on Facebook, on LinkedIn, on Instagram. You can probably call me, but it'll just go to voicemail because I'm probably on the phone with someone else. But you can still call. Every email and my website everywhere has my number. I don't know it off the top of my head, so I apologize. I could probably look it up, but nobody calls anymore these days anyways, so we all email and text and message. So feel free to reach out if you have any questions, if you want to know if you need bookkeeping, if you need a consultation. I answer all my emails, you know, generally within one business day, so you will hear back from me right away. And I am taking a poll on my new book title. So far we have We Keep Your Book So You Can Keep Your Money and How Not to Go to Jail. If you have any other votes, Adam, we're going to do a poll at some point. Okay, great. And then I'll see you guys next week, 7 p.m. Eastern, on Facebook Live for the Bottom Line Live. Thank you so much for joining. I'll see you next time. Bye.